video, we're going to show you how to set up the software settings on an A&D traffic light scale. These scales are used all over the world for different applications, and most of them are indoors, but when you want to use a scale outdoors, sometimes the high speed of this scale can make it a little bit too sensitive. So one of the things we're going to do is slow down the speed so it's optimised for outdoor use. Okay, firstly, obviously when it's out of the box, you want to make sure you've put the batteries inside in that panel underneath, and make sure the screws are done up nice and tight because it is used in a wet area and it's waterproof. Okay, now to go into the functions, these functions are covered in the instruction manual, pages 20 through to 23, and in this particular image you can see I've highlighted the ones we're going to change. We're going to change about four or five of the function settings. Okay, so to get into it to start with, you can see this scale here out of the box is set to be 3 kilo by half a gram. Now we're going to change it to be 1 gram because that's more than enough accuracy for most punnet applications. Now to get into the software settings, now keep in mind these are not clicky buttons like normal, these are hard touch keys. We actually need to press and hold two keys at the same time. So while we're touching the green key, we basically press this on, and then as soon as you see the software version come up, you let go, and it goes to the first function, which is the power off function. It doesn't stand for piss off, which a lot of people think it might. On some software versions, it will come up with the word lock. That just means it's an extra function on a later software version. Okay, so moving through, the power off will leave set at 1, because what that means is after 5 minutes of use, it's going to turn the scale off. You can disable that or make that longer if you want to. Now these keys here, you can see the four buttons, basically three of them have a secondary function. Underneath this one you can see an up arrow, this one's got a right arrow, and this one's got like an enter symbol. What happens is if we press the up arrow, that number changes, you can see, to a different value. And like I said, refer to the instruction manual for the exact details. So here the power off function, you can see you've got a setting of 0 to 5, and we just want to leave it at number 1. Then if we hit the right hand arrow, it goes to the next setting. Now this is the resolution, which is at the moment by half a gram. We want to change that to 0. So again, we press the button until it says 0. Now that means it's going by 1 gram. Now the next one is a little bit hard to understand, but you get used to it. This scale is used all over the world, so it's used in pounds, ounces, some weird and wonderful units that they use in different parts of the world. What we want to do is turn off everything except grams. Now the ones that are active, and you can see pounds is the first one that comes up, it says it's actually switched on because that circle is there. To turn off the circle, you press the green key, and you can see now the circle's gone. And if we scroll through all the different units, there's ounces, we just turn off the ones we don't want, leave on the ones we do want. Basically, when you're scrolling through them, most of them are on and we're turning them off. Some of them are already off. So when we go through here, turn off basically everything except for grams. So when you get to grams, leave that on. So you can see there, grams is on. We want to leave that on. Go to the next one, which is kilos, turn that off. So now if you just quickly tap this, going through every single unit, you'll see the only one you want to have with a circle is grams, and then you move to the next setting. Okay, most of these, like I said, we're not going to change. Let's go to this one, which is the most important one. This is the speed that we talked about before, and you can see the setting in the manual. You can choose 0 for the fastest and 4 for the slowest. So for a typical outdoor application, we'll go with 3, which is the second slowest. And then if you do want to come and change it afterwards, change it to 4 if you find it still a little bit sensitive. The next one we'll change is just to make the backlight as bright as possible for outdoors, so that goes to number 4. Then the only other one we're really going to mess around with is the traffic lights. This CP-L we want to change to 3. That means that only the red and green lights are going to come on for a high, low and okay symbol. And the very last one we're going to change is the intensity of the traffic lights, which we can change to maximum, which I think is also 4. So that's done. Now we've finished, we just press the enter key, it says end. And now you can see all we need to do is change the actual settings of our, choose our set points. You can see the scale now is going up by 1 gram increments. Now, if we're filling 250 gram strawberry punnets, we might want to set 265 as our low limit and 300 as our high limit. So to do that, we just touch and hold this key until the low value comes on. You can see it says low here, and we just use these arrow keys to set the value to what we want. When the one's flashing that you want to change, you just increment it with this one, 1, 2, go across, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, across again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, now it's 265, press again, go to the high value, 1, 2, 3, it's now 300 for our high value. Now we've basically saved that. You can see that between 265 and 300, it's okay. Anything above is red, anything below is red. And that's the scale setup. So, like I said, refer to the manual if you want to make any alterations to those settings.